So again, we are checking out the Nintendo Direct E3 of 2021. This is the one that I've been most hyped for out of all the presentations. So I am really looking forward to this year. I really hope we see some Breath of the Wild, maybe some new Smash, maybe a new Mario Kart, a new Donkey Kong game. There's so many speculations, and it's finally gonna fall into our laps right now. So I'm just getting the pre-show, well, not like the pre-show, but just getting ready for the introduction here. I got my snacks, got some Gatorade for about a 40-minute presentation. I know there's probably going to be a lot of weird filler stuff, so we'll see how that goes. But should be starting here pretty soon. Hopefully my internet doesn't give out. It's been acting up lately, so I'm really hoping that it does not cut out during the presentation. This is something that you're into. I'm gonna need a granola bar in front of the microphone. Here we go. We rock and roll.
Hello, everyone. I'm Shinya Takahashi, and I'll be your guide for today's Nintendo Direct.
Hello, I'm Yoshiaki Koizumi, and I'll be your guide as well.
The Nintendo Switch system is now in its fifth year, and many people around the world are playing games on it. Nintendo Switch is being enjoyed by a wide range of players spanning all ages and all levels of gaming experience. Thank you all very much. We've been able to offer a wide variety of games on the system, not just from Nintendo, but also from our many development and publishing partners. I hope that each of you watching this Nintendo Direct will be able to find a game that suits your personal tastes.
Breath of the Wild 2, please.
Today, we have news on upcoming Nintendo Switch games, and we'll be focusing on a selection of games releasing this year. We hope you enjoy it. Okay, to begin, please take a look at this video.
What? No, this is not it. Didn't expect that, dude. What the heck? Everyone was saying it was Crash Bandicoot, but there may be a chance that he's in this. Moves. He's just throwing everybody off. More Sonic or anybody, dude. Getting more Street Fighter in here. Oh, Tekken, I'm sorry, not Tekken. I mean... That's pretty cool.
Hello, I'm Masahiro Sakurai from Sora Limited, and the director of the Super Smash Bros. Ultimate game. Kazuya Mishima from the fighting game series Tekken will join the battle. Surprise! I'll go over the details at a later date, so please sit tight. For today, though, we've prepared a short video to showcase Kazuya's moves in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please take a look.
Alright, well. Maybe this is not who I thought it was going to be. I thought it was somebody else in Street Fighter, but... So, excuse my fake whoa. Crazy that we're going to see, like, someone from Tekken and then, like, Super Mario Brothers. That's crazy. See, I think that's how they started it last time. They did, like, the character that everyone was like, yeah, it's okay. The big one was in the middle, like, with Banjo-Kazooie.
This feels like Tekken. No, it's Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I'll talk about the fighter more in a future presentation. We still have to record it first, actually. The air date is shown below. Please stay tuned.
28. Nice. Cool.
Thank you, Mr. Sakurai.
You're welcome.
New fighter Kazuya will join the fight in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. Please look forward to seeing how Kazuya, who has experienced many harsh battles across the Tekken series, will fight in this game. All right, let's continue with our first batch of Nintendo Switch headlines.
Your choices matter in these emotional supernatural tales.
It always starts off with these anime games. It's always hilarious. Life is Strange. Yeah. I've heard of those games. I heard they're pretty cool from what my friend told me.
Life is Strange True Colors launches on Nintendo Switch September 10th. And Life is Strange Remastered Collection comes to Nintendo Switch later this year. There's something for everyone on the Nintendo Switch system.
Is there?
You are Star-Lord.
Oh,
leading
wow.
A legendary band of heroes
Guardians are going on
in
her?
This thrilling action-adventure game.
That's
jump
cool.
On a wild ride across the cosmos, overwhelm opponents with Star-Lord's daring combat style, and encounter iconic and original
are
Marvel
the graphics
characters.
Look like this?
You'll
that's
call
cool.
The
they're
shots for
on...
the unpredictable Guardians as you face cosmic
cool. I didn't know that it was going
to
make it on the Switch, but the vendors are not
this,
on the Switch.
Probably. Marvel's Guardians of the Galaxy blasts onto Nintendo Switch October 26th.
Wow, day and day with the other ones.
Worms everywhere. In this real-time arena-based shooter, you'll squish your invertebrate opponents in 32-player cross-platform combat, play in daily challenges, battle modes, and seasonal events to worm your way up the ranks. Plus, the Patchwork Bear outfit, exclusive to the Nintendo Switch version, will be available for free for 2 weeks after launch. A new map, Spaceport Showdown, launches with Worms Rumble wriggling onto Nintendo Switch June 23rd. Get a 25% discount when you pre-order the game starting today on Nintendo eShop. The fantastical realm of Orcanon awaits. As you explore this fully hand-painted world, you'll customize a team of demigods and unleash devastating attacks and captivating turn-based combat.
I mean, it looks cool, but it's nothing I'm interested in. But if you're into that, no problem. September 30th.
Return to the funny, charming, and quirky world of Two Point County. In the wholesome management sim Two Point Campus, you'll build and run your very own university the way you want it. Lots of creative tools are at your disposal to make the school yours and take your educational empire to the next level. Enrollment for Two Point Campus starts on Nintendo Switch next year. A beloved series rolls into its 20th anniversary this year.
Oh, yeah. I don't think I ever actually fully played a Monkey Ball game. Okay. For real, they're gonna celebrate Super Monkey Ball, but they're not gonna do Legend of Zelda. Seriously? Where is the 35th anniversary for Zelda? That better be in here, man. I'm wearing a Zelda shirt. I put it on for this reason. I feel like this game would be way too frustrating for me to play. I feel like I just get mad the whole time.
Go bananas when Super Monkey Ball Banana Mania rolls onto Nintendo Switch October 5th.
Okay.
It's a blast from parties past, and you're invited. Ready for another round of Mario Party Mayhem? Of course you are. It's a superstar collection of Mario Party boards and minigames. Live it up on five classic boards from the Nintendo 64 era, including Peach's Birthday Cake and Space Raid.
Finally!
Each board is packed with zany events guaranteed to keep you on your toes. And when we say zany, we mean it.
Now this is what I'm talking about.
Jump. Connect blocks. And give facelifts? In hilarious over-the-top minigames.
Okay, is this a
all
new...
All of which support button controls.
Oh, thank
with
God.
100 minigames from the Mario Party series catalog.
Is this new or is this additional content?
This All-Star Fun Fest. Here's a little party favor. All game modes work with online play.
Thank God, Nintendo. Seriously.
Even if you're partying solo, you can randomly match with other partygoers worldwide.
Finally! Oh my God!
Playing a game online with friends? Save your progress mid-game, grab a snack, then resume the festivities. Stickers are also available to communicate with others.
Okay.
It's time to party in Mario Party Superstars, launching on the Nintendo Switch system October 29th.
Oh, so it's new.
Begin today on Nintendo eShop.
Okay, I thought it was an add-on to Super Mario Party. Well, I guess we're...
Before we show this next trailer, I'd like to say one thing. Currently, we're working hard on the latest game in the Metroid Prime series,
yes!
Metroid Prime 4, which we previously announced. But today, we'd like to introduce another new entry in the Metroid franchise.
Oh, okay.
Please take a look.
So the rumors were true. They're showing another Metroid game. Oh, they're doing it! They're doing Metroid 5! Man, I know a lot of people are going to be excited for this. I'll definitely play this for sure. I actually really do like Metroid. I'm more of a Metroid Prime guy, but these Metroid games are pretty cool. Metroid Dread. This year? Oh. It looks... Oh my gosh. Dude, people are going to flip finally, we're getting Metroid on Switch. Oh, this looks dope. I feel like Metroid is incredibly underrated. I feel like not a lot of people play it. They should, man. Metroid's super cool. Kind of like, it looks like a 2.5D type game. Alright, when's it dropping? It's gotta be this year. Oh, they're gonna play it in Treehouse. Nice. Oh, yeah. I knew it. That means Metroid Prime 4 is not happening this year. There's no way.
That was the trailer for the first new 2D Metroid game in roughly 19 years. The brand new Metroid Dread game. As the name Dread implies, this is a Metroid game with a new feel showcasing a variety of threats that Samus will encounter. It's scheduled to be released on October 8th, so it won't be too long until launch. On that same day, we'll also be releasing amiibo figures for
that's
Samus
gonna go,
and the
that's
enemy,
gonna sell like hotcakes.
The robot seen in the video. Let's move on to more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Oh, is that it? They're not going to talk about Metroid Prime 4? Dude.
These familiar franchises are back on Nintendo Switch.
That's all right. Get ready to get down
in the latest Just Dance game.
I hate when they have to, like, fill it with stuff like this. No one cares about Just Dance.
Hit the dance floor in Just Dance 2022, launching on Nintendo Switch November 4th.
Ugh, no thanks. Ooh, this looks fun.
The arcade smash hit Cruisin' Blast is speeding onto Nintendo Switch.
I'll play this. Looks like a side truck.
Blast your way through nearly 30 over-the-top
tracks.
What
the heck? Is that a unicorn?
Up to four players can race together, so pick your favorite vehicle and hit the road. Cruisin' Blast launches as a console exclusive on Nintendo Switch this fall.
Wow.
It's the ultimate Dragon Ball Z experience.
Look, we always get Dragon Ball Z in Nintendo Directs.
Relive the story of Goku and other Z fighters through four sagas in this action RPG.
Oh, nice. That's cool.
Protect the Earth from an invasion by Vegeta and Nappa. Frieza, take a stand against the evil Emperor. Cell, battle the androids in a fight to the death. Majin Buu, an epic showdown with the most fearsome foe.
I've played more Dragon Ball Z games than I have watched the actual show.
Hey, why not?
My friend Chisholm's a huge fan, but I've never really watched his show.
You could always train to acquire new skills too.
This looks pretty sick. That'd be fun.
Keep you busy. The boss battle episodes, A New Power Awakens, parts 1 and 2 is also included. Dragon Ball Z Kakarot plus A New Power Awakens set
plus A New Power
Awakens Nintendo Switch September 24th.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Grab a golf club and get ready to tee off.
They're only doing this because this game drops like next week, I think.
The Mario Golf Super Rush game launches soon. Here's a quick glimpse
into
each of the modes. Standard golf. Take your time to read the wind and terrain on the greens.
Honestly, golf games are fun, especially if they're like just Mario kind of goofy.
Hit different types of shots and aim for under par.
Nice birdie.
Speed golf. Smack your ball, then chase after it. Be the first to get your ball in the hole.
This mode would be pretty fun, I think.
Outpace your rivals with special dashes and special shots.
Paulina, whatever her name is.
Battle golf.
Battle golf.
Duke it out over 9 flag marked holes in an obstacle-filled arena.
It's like Mario Kart.
Capture 3 flags
golf.
To win. Golf adventure. Go from rookie to pro with your Mii character.
What?
The golfing challenges that await may surprise you. And here's some news. Free updates are planned for future release, including additional courses and playable characters.
New Donk City.
The fairway's almost open. So set your tee time and get ready to ace those shots in Mario Golf Super Rush, swinging onto the Nintendo Switch system June 25th. Pre-orders are available now on Nintendo eShop. Ready for the ride of a lifetime?
No, I'm not.
Welcome to the vast and vibrant world of Monster Hunter. As a rider in this RPG adventure, you'll explore diverse landscapes by riding your Monstie, a monster companion. Gather materials such as honey and ore, then use them to craft items for your journey. But beware of the many monsters roaming about. Some are docile, but others may suddenly ambush you. To fight, you'll team up with your Monstie and use weapons and skills to overwhelm enemy monsters in turn-based battles. Win, and you'll be rewarded with their materials, which can be forged into new weapons and armor.
See, I just am not, I don't know, not a fan of,
Is that an egg? You might be
able to get
a
new
Monstie.
Aye.
Incredibly powerful Monsties can
crack
also
an egg
from rare eggs. Need more traveling buddies? Join up with friends for co-op multiplayer quests and battles. Buckle up, Ryder. It's going to be a real monster of an adventure.
Oh, gosh.
Monster Hunter Stories 2, Wings of Ruin, soars onto Nintendo Switch July 9th. You can play the free demo on June 25th and carry over your save data to the full game.
Wow!
Here's a new game of a certain company.
WarioWare, please. No, WarioWare. Yes!
Did you miss me? Hey, what do you mean? Who am I?
It's Wario! Me.
Wario!
I heard the man.
Just finally ready. A brand new game from my company. Check it out. You get to control me.
I love WarioWare, dude. WarioWare is so fun.
Look at me go. What rats. Check out these chunks. They came back. And they have wonderful new talents.
This is the most Wario's ever talked.
Throw that stick thing. Not the bad. Use the spinny, whatchamacallit. Ha! Nailed it. Same micro game, different abilities. Wah! I almost forgot some big news. Two people can play together at the same time.
Sweet.
So play nice, or else. Eh? Not nice. All right, you. Yes, you, the one watching this. Better get ready for some micro game mayhem.
The Wario Get It Together
game it's gonna be Treehouse
exclusively
sick.
On the Nintendo Switch system September
10th. Get it together.
Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo
Switch. Nice. Oh, man, I love WarioWare. People need to play those games, man. They're so fun.
What you just saw was the trailer for WarioWare. Get It Together. In the latest installment of this series, there are new microgames that let you control Wario and his friends. There is also a two-player co-op mode, which greatly expands the gameplay. It's releasing in the near future, so stay tuned. Next, please take a look at this.
As a high school student living in Tokyo, your life is fairly normal. But that reality is upended after you get pulled into a different dimension. Another Tokyo exists, a post-apocalyptic world where angels and demons reside. Suddenly, you fuse with a mysterious figure, gaining the power to fight demons. What lies ahead in this alternate realm? Transformed into a sprawling, demon-infested wasteland. Though friendly demons do exist here, many are hostile and will attempt to destroy you. Harness your newfound powers to fight demons using a command-based system. Finding their weak point is key. By targeting it, the number of consecutive actions you can perform in a combo will increase. Though demons are formidable opponents.
Yeah, not impressive.
Them via negotiations, which begin when you open a conversation with them.
What? You don't need that.
If a negotiation is successful, a demon will become a powerful ally. In some cases, by rejecting a demon's request, they may feel motivated and join you as an ally. Demons that do join will fight alongside you and grow stronger. By fusing demon allies, another demon can be created.
They're spending too much time on this. Let's move on.
The newly fused demon's innate abilities will vary, granting you a powerful ally, customized to your needs and playstyle.
The more I watch this, the more I wish this was Bayonetta 3.
This
post-apocalyptic world. I better be in here too, man.
By harnessing the power of your own. What destiny will you choose? Shin Megami Tensei 5 will launch exclusively on Nintendo Switch November 12th. Pre-orders for the physical version begin June 21st.
That was the latest trailer for Shin Megami Tensei 5 from Atlus. This is the newest game in the series. Please look forward to future updates.
Okay.
Let's see a few more Nintendo Switch headlines.
Give me something good, baby. Give me something good.
Celebrate 10 years of Danganronpa in despair.
Testing, testing. Mic check, 1, 2. This is a test of the school broadcast system.
What the heck is this?
Three games in the deadly Danganronpa series are coming to Nintendo Switch.
What? I don't even know what this is. I thought it was Five Nights at Freddy's.
Monokuma, the self-proclaimed school headmaster, has trapped you and other high school students in a game of literal life and death. Unfortunately, the only way out of the school and this lethal game is to betray the other students. And so it begins.
A body has been discovered!
When a student meets their demise, a class trial will take place to reveal the culprit.
You're the culprit, aren't you, Mew?
Tanya, I had no idea.
They probably moved the body there.
Use the evidence you've gathered to refute contradictions and find the guilty party.
Sneak attack! No, it's wrong!
Are you okay?
No, I'm not. Whoa, what the heck is this?
The board game from Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony has been expanded into a standalone game. Danganronpa S Ultimate Summer Camp. An all-star cast of characters from the Danganronpa series will come together to battle at a tropical resort. Who's the strongest of them all in this ultimate beach brawl? The four-game collection Danganronpa Decadence launches as a physical exclusive on Nintendo Switch later this year. Okay. All four games will also be individually available on Nintendo eShop. We hope you're not afraid of ghosts.
I love how it seems like a kindergartner. You hope you're not afraid. I am afraid. I'm afraid that I'm not going to show anything else good. There's only
in
like 10 minutes left.
Adventure game, you'll uncover the mysteries surrounding the ethereal but deadly Mount Hikami, like, believed to be at the center
fine,
of many
but
disappearances.
I just don't really have an
Ghosts
interest.
Ghosts frequent
though.
This mountain. Your only defense is a camera that can repel and cast them out.
So it's like the Ouija's Mansion.
As you explore a variety of unsettling locations.
But the Ouija's Mansion is actually fun.
This spine-chilling story features various protagonists, letting you experience the game from different perspectives. New costumes and photo modes are included in this version. Can you investigate Mount Hikami and stay alive? Fatal Frame, Maiden of Black Water, creeps onto Nintendo Switch this year. These games and DLC are coming soon, some even today.
Today? Doom Eternal, baby.
Your war is not over. Raise hell in
love
the
that
first
game.
Campaign expansion for Doom Eternal, The Ancient Gods Part 1.
Game looks pretty good on Switch, to be honest, and it runs well, too.
Deeper and more challenging combat awaits as you eliminate Hell's newest threats in demon-infested ruins and rain-swept terrain.
Dude, Ancient Gods is freaking hard. Don't let anyone tell you that it's not. It's hard, man. Your hands.
Get slaying when this campaign expansion launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
Nice.
Get ramped
oh,
up
yeah.
with two iconic skateboarding games fully remastered in HD.
When does this drop? I have it on PS4, but I'll probably get it on Switch again.
And returning pros. Take your sessions on the go with all the original game modes. And compete locally or online to show off your tricks
online.
Against other skaters.
You can do online with Switch?
Drop
nice.
Into Tony Hawk's Pro Skater 1 and 2, launching on Nintendo Switch June 25th.
June 25th?
Pre-orders are available now on it's Nintendo
like, what,
eShop.
Next week? That's next week, yeah.
After 4,000 years, Satechi, the Witch Queen, has risen from the
Satechi.
Dead.
Satechi.
And only one group of heroes can stop her. The Strange Brigade.
Okay.
In this thrilling adventure, you'll blast through an army of mummified monstrosities while solving puzzles in booby-trapped dungeons. Go it alone or team up with other daring adventurers in local wireless co-op and online play. Expect the unexpected when Strange Brigade launches on Nintendo Switch later today.
Oh. That's alright, I guess.
It's a new adventure.
All right,
cosmic
something
proportions.
I care about. Let's do it. I'm going to show more gameplay. This game
Mario
looks awesome.
And his friends will team up with the rabbits.
I love the first one. I put like 110 hours
into
the first one.
Our heroes must stop a mysterious new evil from plunging the universe
Cursa.
Into chaos. Rabbit Rosalina joins them. Wait, is she bored already? Explore planets filled with quirky residents and even quirkier secrets.
Okay, we've seen this already. I wanted to go to show
on the tactical genre. Our heroes can run freely around the battlefield,
creating
new strategic and chaotic possibilities. So aim for victory with a little help from your friends.
So I guess
who's that?
I guess they are changing
well,
it up a little bit.
Certain, this is gonna be one heck of a galactic adventure. Mario plus Rabbids Sparks of Hope launches into space or onto Nintendo Switch next year.
It's cool that you kind of have freedom to move around. What is that? See, this is the kind of thing I'm talking about, man. Like, no one wants to see this. And if you do, okay, I'm sorry, but I'm pretty sure the majority of people don't want to see this.
Memorable characters and vibrant gameplay are in store as you lead the commanding officers to victory. Play the first two Advance Wars campaigns in Advance Wars 1 plus 2 Reboot Camp, marching on to Nintendo Switch this holiday. Pre-orders begin today on Nintendo eShop.
How is everything?
It's all right.
All right. This next segment will be our last announcement of the day.
What?
Please, take a look.
Dude, I swear to God, it better be Zelda. I guess it's kind of Zelda, but that weapon looks pretty cool, though. Pulse of the Ancients. dude.
Hello there. I'm Eiji Aonuma, producer of the Legend of Zelda series.
Don't tease us like last
time. What
you've
just seen is a trailer for the first wave of DLC for the Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity expansion pass from Koei Tecmo Games.
Come on, show us something.
It will follow Link and his allies through more battles that took place 100 years prior to the events of The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild.
Okay.
I hope you'll look forward to it.
Yes, Breath of the Wild 2.
I have a few more things to share with you all today.
Oh, please.
We'll begin with The Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword HD game, which launches next month. You'll immerse yourself in the role of Link by using two Joy-Con controllers for intuitive motion controls, or by playing in handheld mode, wielding the sword via flicking the stick and button-only controls. This game depicts the oldest era in The Legend of Zelda series, the story of how it all began. What is the origin of the Master Sword? Why did a woman named Zelda become the legend for future generations? These will all be unraveled in this game. We hope you're looking
forward excited.
To The Legend of Zelda.
I didn't
Skyward
own this
Sword
game on the
HD.
Wii, so I am excited to play this one. Dude.
Next up.
Well, I mean,
here's a little something you might like.
It's kind of an anniversary.
This is a Game & Watch system that lets you play three games in the Legend of Zelda series.
Dude, I could tell
this
everybody
year,
right now
Legend
is having
Zelda
like
reaches its 35th
a pit
anniversary.
In their stomach. Finally,
we don't have any campaigns or other Nintendo Switch games planned. We've been working on this Game & Watch system as a special item to help mark the occasion and reflect fondly on the earliest days of The Legend of Zelda.
Okay.
It will come with the first game in the series, The Legend of Zelda.
Oh, it's got multiple
Zelda
games
2,
in it? Oh,
The Adventure
cool.
of Link.
It's still got multiple games in it. Oh,
and
nice.
A version of The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening game.
Oh, man.
As well as a special version of the Game & Watch title Vermin, starring Link as the playable character. So
that's
four
cool.
games on one system, from longer Legend of Zelda games to the pick-up-and-play game Vermin. In addition, regarding the watch functionality for the Game & Watch system, we've added a playable clock based on The Legend of Zelda, and an interactive timer themed after Zelda 2, The Adventure of Link.
Okay, everybody,
both of
I'm
them
telling you,
taking control of Link.
I have a pet in my son. They better show Breath of the Wild 2, man.
We hope you'll enjoy playing this Game & Watch system whenever and wherever you'd like. All right, here's the last thing we have to show you.
Come on.
This is the sequel to The Legend of Zelda Breath
yes!
of the Wild. 2 years have passed since
yes!
we first announced this game, and we've been unable to share anything with you in that time.
Please.
However, development has been steadily progressing. For today, we've prepared some new footage to show a bit more of the game.
Oh,
please
thank
take
God.
A look.
Yes. What's happening? Zelda! Oh! Yeah, man! Oh! Yeah! Oh, yeah! Nice! Oh, yeah, dude! That it? That all we're getting? Okay, give me a name at least. Yeah, 2022. We need the name. Did we get a name?
So, what did you think? This time around, the setting for the adventure has been expanded to include the skies above Hyrule.
Yes!
We'd like to ask you to wait a bit longer. We're aiming for a 2022 release, so I hope you'll look forward to it.
Still no name!
That's all for this Nintendo Direct. We are diligently continuing development on a number of other games we didn't show today. I hope you'll continue looking forward to what's in store on Nintendo Switch. Thank you for watching.
Okay, well, I mean, it was all right. I mean, it wasn't like anything spectacular. Honestly, Xbox probably had the best presentation so far, and this is the last one that I'm watching. And so, honestly, it was kind of disappointing, but at the same time, it was all right, because we got to see more Breath of the Wild. Okay, well, I hope you guys enjoyed the video here. I'm not going to do like any break. I'm going to do a breakdown on my podcast, the Chandler Burton podcast, if you guys are interested in that. That'll be up here probably on Friday. So I'll leave a link. I'll try to leave a link for that below for the podcast. And I'll put a picture up here somewhere as well, so you guys can keep an eye out for that if you want to know my whole thoughts on E3. But thanks again for watching along with me here. And I hope you all have a good rest of your day. Take care.